Hi students, this is Kartik Trivedi and you are watching a lecture series of Applied Thermodynamics with me.
Students, in today's video, we're gonna see a different psychrometric processes. So our title is psychrometric processes and this is very important as far as GTU examination is concerned. Okay, so this is very important topic. Pay attention and listen to me very carefully. Okay, let us start with the first process, which is sensible cooling. Now, whenever I use word sensible, that means what? Temperature changes is happening, no moisture is going to be added. And when I say latent heat added, latent heat removed, so in psychrometry, when you add the moisture or when you add the when you remove the moisture, so at that time you have to talk about in terms of latent heat. So in psychrometry, latent heat means when you add moisture or remove the moisture, so that is something related to latent heat. In sensible heat, you will not adding the moisture, or sensible heating or sensible cooling, you will not adding the moisture, only the temperature changes is happening. So sensible in psychrometry, sensible heating is related with only temperature changes, no moisture added. And when I say latent heat added, latent heat removed means either moisture is added or moisture removed. So this is what something related to psychrometry. And when I say moisture added means water vapor added into the air. And when I say moisture removed means water vapor removed. So this is something, moisture means water vapor. Okay, so remember this in mind. So first process is sensible cooling. So here we are going to reduce the temperature. So if you see over here, there is this air which is coming at the temperature TD1. So TD1 means it is entering at a TD1 means tribal temperature 1. So air that is coming over here is at a TD1 means it is tribal temperature 1. Here you can see the cooling coil in which refrigerant in and refrigerant out. And this cooling coil is at temperature TD3 means tribal temperature 3. So what will happen as the air passes through over here? It will be cools down with the help of refrigerant which is in the cooling coil. So what will happen? The cooling air will be come out. So the cooling air which is coming out at the temperature TD2. So dryable temperature 2. So when I say TD2 means dryable temperature 2. So air in TD1, air out at TD2, and here at the cooling coil heat will be absorbed. So cooling coil at a temperature TD3. Okay, so this is called sensible cooling process. Now what is happening? So now if I want to show this sensible cooling process in psychrometry chart, then how I can explain? So here you can see that psychrometry chart. So this is point 1 at which the air is entering. So this is point 1. At point 1 we have tribal temperature TD1. And at this point we have relative humidity phi 1. So this is relative humidity. You know that this symbol, the cow, which is relative humidity. Now what is happening? We have removed the heat. So what is happening? Temperature will be decreased. So that's why you can say 1 to 2. So here at 2, you can see that the heat is removed. So this is sensible cooling. So at point 2, you will have temperature TD2. Now our process is just 1 to 2, but why I have shown 0.3 over here? I have shown the 0.3 over here for your explanation. If this cooling coil, if this is cooling coil is behaving, or you can say is performing with 100% efficiency, if this cooling coil is performing with the 100% efficiency, then what is happening? Then our air will be come out with the temperature TD3. But in actual, we know that no cooling coil is having efficiency of 100%. So we have the temperature more than the cooling coil. So if the cooling coil is performing with 100% efficiency, then we have process 1, 2, 3, and at 0.3 we have temperature TD3. But we know that cooling coil does not have 100% efficiency. So our temperature which is coming out, which is slightly more than the cooling coil. Okay, so this we are having, our process will be completed at 0.2. So this is the our real process 1 to 2. This is sensible cooling. But if it is happening with ideal condition, it will be 1 to 3. So at 3 the temperature will be TD3. But only sensible cooling here with our process is only 1 to 2. So this is 1 to 2. So this is how we can show it. So this is sensible cooling. So you can see that here you can see that the specific humidity for 0.122. So how to find specific humidity? So from here draw straight horizontal line, and here you can see that 0.1 and 0.2 have same specific humidity, means humidity constant. So no latent heat remove, only sensible cooling. So only change in dryable temperature. Second thing you can see that the dew point temperature is also constant. So how to find dew point temperature? So draw straight horizontal line like this. So DPT will be also same for 0.1 and 0.2. Now what is happening over here, you can see that the relative humidity increase. So here 5.1 and 5.2, you know that whenever you are reaching nearer to the saturation curve, because we know that this saturation curve is having 100% efficiency, 100% relative humidity. So when you are reaching nearer to the saturation curve, your relative humidity increase. So at 0.1 it will be 5.1, at 0.2 it will be 5.22. So relative humidity will be increases. So at 0.1 you can find the enthalpy something like this. So this is WBT line at 0.1. If you extend this WBT line, it will source the enthalpy H1, and at 0.2 you will have enthalpy H2. So this is a graphical representation of the sensible cooling process in psychrometry chart. So this is shows the sensible cooling. Okay, now how to find the heat removed? To find the heat removed, we have equation MCP delta T. M means mass flow rate of air. Here CP means humid specific heat. CPM, humid specific heat. You have to remember that value will be 1.022 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. CPM is humid specific heat, 1.022 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And delta T means heat removal. So TD1 minus TD2. Okay. So this is mass flow rate, CPM, TD1 minus TD2. But sometime you have to find, for the finding the mass flow rate, what you have to do? So you know that mass flow rate, to find the mass, you require, you know, the density, volume. To find the mass flow rate, sometime you will be have to find density into volumetric flow rate. So we know that density of air is what? 1.2. So that's why I've written 1.2 multiply by volumetric flow rate. So volumetric flow rate, so it will, sometime in example it will give you in meter cube per minute. So what you have to do, you have to convert into meter cube per second. So this is volumetric flow rate into CPM, TD1 minus TD2, then and then only you can find the answer in kilowatt, okay, kilojoule per second. Or else you can find the heat removed in terms of kilojoule per kg. How? So at 0.1, see the enthalpy H1. At 0.2, see the enthalpy of H2. So heat removed will be H1 minus H2 in terms of kilojoule per kg. Okay, so this is the sensible cooling process. Now the same thing, sensible heating. So I will not going to draw the same diagram over here, but in exam you have to draw it. So what will the changes will be happen in terms of cooling coil? We will be having a heating coil. So same thing over here. Only the process is going to be reversed. So now what you have to do, you have to assume in place of this cooling coil, you will assume heating coil over here. So the same process we can represent over here. So you can see that this is 0.1. This is 0.2, sensible heating, heat increase, so TD1 to TD2. And if it is happening with ideal condition, then the process will be 1 to 3. So TD3, but we know that heating coil will not perform with 100% efficiency, so our temperature will be slightly less than the 0.3. So our real process is 1 to 2. 1 to 3 solves the ideal process if coil performs with 100% efficiency. But our real process will be 1 to 2. Here you can see that temperature increase TD1 to TD2. Here the enthalpy H1, here the enthalpy H2. So here you can say that the W1 equal to W2, same thing, humidity constant, only temperature increase. That means what? That means it is sensible heating. So same way, heat added. So how you can find heat added in terms of kilojoule per kg? You can find H2 minus H1, bigger enthalpy minus smaller enthalpy. Okay, so this is how you can find it. So here the bigger enthalpy, so you can say that over here H2 minus H1. Or same way over here, if you want to write 1.2 means density of air, volumetric flow rate of air, CPM, TD2 minus TD1 kilowatt. So this is how you can find it. So this is sensible heating, this is sensible cooling. Now there is also one term that I want to explain you, which is bypass factor. So what is bypass factor? So you know that the here the cooling coil is over here, 100% air cannot be passed through coil. There will be a somewhere which is bypassing the coil, means it does not come into the contact. So bypass factor is equal to fraction of air that does not pass through the coil. So that is, there is some amount of air which cannot pass through the coil. So here you can see that, let us say there will be a total 1 kg of air entering. So what is happening, x kg of air bypassing over here, means x kg of air does not come in contact with the coil. Only 1 minus x kg of air will come into the contact of the coil, and after the mixture of these two will be here 1 kg again, x plus 1 minus x. So here we have TD2 temperature. So let us see, this is heating coil over here. Now we can use energy balance over here. So how to do energy balance? We know that at entering heat will be what, MCP delta T. So let's say x kg of, so what we will do here, let us say the x kg of air will be bypassing. So x kg over m. So here for m will be x kg. What will be the bypass? So CPM likhenge. CPM. So we will write CPM over here. And it is bypassing. So bypassing, that means it does not come with the contact with the coil. So coil is at temperature T3. If it does not come in contact, then notice it is bypassing with the initial temperature, means TD1. So that's why TD1 over here. Plus whatever come into the contact. So 1 minus x kg come into the contact. So 1 minus x kg m CPM and temperature. So what will be the temperature? So whatever will come into the contact, it will be that temperature will be going to be the same with heating coil. So heating coil temperature TD3. So all temperature is going to be happen with TD3. So air temperature is going to be happen TD3. So x kg, which is bypassing, 1 minus x kg, which is come in contact, equals to final condition. So final condition, you are having a temperature TD2. So equal to final condition means this x kg plus 1 minus x kg. So final it, the total kg will be 1 kg into CPM into final temperature will be what? TD2. So now make x as a subject. So here you can find x value something like this. So it shows this much amount of air is bypassing for heating coil. Heating coil, x will be bypass factor, x will be value will be this. Same way for cooling coil, it will be reverse of this. So it will be TD2 minus TD3 upon TD1 minus TD3. Why? Because we know that heating coil, we will have a more TD3 temperature will be more. So it will be something like that. And for cooling coil, it will be something like this, because TD3 temperature will be less. So TD2 minus TD3 upon TD1 minus TD3. So this bypass factor equation is for cooling coil and this bypass factor for heating coil. So we know that efficiency of coil will be 1 minus bypass factor. So if you have to find the efficiency of heating coil, so 1 minus bypass factor of heating coil. And if you want to find the efficiency of cooling coil, so that will be equal to 1 minus bypass factor of cooling coil. So you have the bypass factor x value for heating coil and bypass factor x value for cooling coil. So you can simply do it. Okay, we will see humidification and dehumidification. So third process, humidification. So here you can see what is humidification. Humidification means you are adding the water vapor, means specific humidity is going to be increased. So that is known as humidification. So here you can see that this process, this psychrometry chart. So this is pure humidification. Pure humidification means only water vapor will be added. So moisture will be added. So what will happen? Specific humidity will be increased. But this is happening at a constant dry bulb temperature. So here you can see that 4.1 and 0.2 dry bulb temperature is same. TD1 equal to TD. So at constant dry bulb temperature, we are adding the water vapor. So that means specific humidity is going to be increased. So you can see that 4.1 specific humidity will be W1 and 4.2 specific humidity will be W2. So you can see that the specific humidity is going to be increased. Water vapor is going to be added. So this is known as pure humidification, because this is happening at a constant dry bulb temperature. So this is known as humidification. So at 4.1, you can see the enthalpy H1, 4.2 enthalpy H2, and you can see that the relative humidity is going to be increases as you will progressing from 0.1 to 0.2. So therefore, here the temperature is remain constant, but water vapor is going to be added. So that is known as latent heat added. So I know that I already told you that in psychrometry, latent heat added means the water vapor is going to be added. Okay, so here, but at a constant dry bulb temperature. So here you can see that, so latent heat added will be equal to what? Bigger enthalpy minus smaller enthalpy. So equal to H2 minus H1, or you can write HFG bracket big humidity minus small specific humidity. So W2 minus W1. So this is known as pure humidification. Now reverse of that will be dehumidification, means water vapor removed at a constant dry bulb temperature. So this is the just reverse process of this. So you can see that over dehumidifications. So here you can see this process, and you can see this from 0.1 to 2, humidity is going to be decreased. Specific humidity is going to be decreased, means water vapor removed at a constant dry bulb temperature. Why constant temperature? 4.1 and 2, dry bulb temperature is going to be same. TD1 equal to TD2. So here enthalpy H1, here enthalpy H2. This is specific relative humidity at 151. This is relative humidity at 52. So relative humidity going to be decreased. So what is the latent heat removed? So latent heat removed is equal to H1 minus H2, bigger enthalpy and smaller enthalpy. Or you can write HFG into bracket W1 minus W2. So this is how you can find this. Okay, so this is humidification and this is dehumidification. Now this is pure humidification and this is pure dehumidification. In actual practice, in actual life, there will be a no pure humidification or there will be a no pure dehumidification, because with humidification and dehumidification, either there will be a cooling or heating along with that. So in real practice, there will be always heating with humidification or heating with dehumidification or cooling with humidification or cooling with dehumidification. Only humidification and only dehumidification will not happen in real practice. So this is theoretical concept, which is pure humidification and pure dehumidification. Okay.